Tonight, Pampa City Mayor Brad Pingle has rescheduled a meeting when the commission planned to announce the new proposed tax rate. Instead of this Friday, the commission will meet next Monday at the M.K. Brown Auditorium. After more than 100 residents showed up to Tuesday's heated commission meeting, Pingle says he wants to clear up a lot of what he says is misinformation. ProNews 7's Marissa Lucero spoke with the mayor, and she joins us now with more. Marissa?
Larry, Mayor Pingle tells me the commission only has 7 days until it must approve the city's budget. But before it can approve it, an official proposed tax increase must be agreed upon.
The city of Pampa is considering raising its current property tax rate by more than 17.5%. And Mayor Brad Pingle says many still have misinformation surrounding the current proposal.
The letter to the editor that was sent out in our Pampa News stated that people's taxes would go up about 17.5%. That was what was in the paper, which that's misleading.
Commissioner Robert Dixon, who sits just left of Pingle, is the one who wrote that letter to the editor, and at Tuesday's meeting, he defended it.
I feel like that I have been sent here as a person that's looking out for the taxpayer. I believe that I've done that, and I will continue to do that.
And many stood along with the commissioner, willing to fight against the proposed hike. Pingle says he never expected that many people. He says the city needs the tax rate increase after many changes were made to the city's appraisal district, another factor being the city's current debt.
There's only $11 million worth of debt that is supported by the tax dollars. Okay, that's going to include the water park, the animal shelter that the people voted on. Those are the two big items that come out. Okay, we roughly $680,000 worth of debt service that we pay annually.
The other $15 million, Pingle says, comes from enterprise funds. And in only 7 days, commissioners have to find a middle ground tax rate.
So if you are 65.
We'll continue to follow this story and bring you any updates as they become available. From the Kennedy Broadcast Center, I'm Marissa Lucero, ProNews 7.